The ADAU1701 DSP unit is an unbalanced 2CH input, 4CH output digital signal processor that uses Analog Devices' high-performance ADAU1701 DSP chip. It features a 28 or 56-bit digital processing engine for audio signal processing, supports a 48 kHz sampling rate, and has built-in 24-bit resolution ADC and DAC with a high dynamic range of up to 98.5 dB. Since it integrates the ADAU1701 DSP chip, this unit supports SigmaStudio programming. We will provide a series of tutorials that will explain in detail how to program this ADAU1701 DSP 2-inch 4-out unit. In the first video, we will focus on the basic operations, including how to connect the DSP preamp and programming board ICP5 for SigmaStudio programming, how to get open-sourced files, how to open demo programs in SigmaStudio, how to write programs to the DSP, and how to restore factory settings if any mistakes are made. The following equipment will be needed: 1 ADAU1701 DSP preamp, 1 programming board ICP5 ICP1 will work as well, 1 PH6 POS cable, 1 USB Type-C cable with communication capability, the ADAU1701 DSP preamp's open-sourced file, and the SigmaStudio software. If you would like to get the open-sourced file, you can download in the product page in our website. There are a SigmaStudio demo program, a HEX file for restoring factory settings, and a basic programming tutorial. The SigmaStudio software can be downloaded directly from the official Analog Devices website. Now let's get started. Step 1. Configure ICP5 and connect it to the computer. First, we need to set the switches on ICP5. Set SW1 USB mode to position 1 USB and SW4 USB mode to position 2I2C. Once the switches are set, connect ICP5 to the computer using the USB Type-C interface. Do not connect ICP5 with the DSP preamp at this time. Open the SigmaStudio software and click on File in the toolbar. Select New Project to create a new project. In the Hardware Configuration page, drag and connect USB, ADAU1701, and E2PROM from the left device area to the hardware configuration area. If the USB turns green, it means that ICP5 has been successfully recognized by the computer. If it is not recognized, try reconnecting ICP5. Let's familiarize ourselves with the SigmaStudio interface. Device area, processor and USB communication module. Hardware configuration area, drag and connect the corresponding processor and USB communication module, and make logical connections. Hardware register, after dragging ADAU1701 into the hardware configuration area, this page will appear. Set the GPIO ports in this page. Schematic toolbox, various algorithms and functional modules. Schematic design area, drag and connect desired functional algorithms from the toolbox to this area. Step 2. Connect ICP5 to the DSP preamp. Power the ADAU1701 DSP preamp using the Type-C port. Connect the ADAU1701 preamp and ICP5 using the 6-pin cable included with ICP5. Now you can start writing the program. Click on Schematic to enter the schematic design area, where we will write the program. If you have programming experience, you can write your own program. If you are new to programming, we recommend modifying the demo program we provided. Click on File, select Open, and open the sample program. The program indicates the functions of various sections, such as the input and potentiometer. If you don't understand it yet, don't worry. We will explain the relationship between the program and the hardware, as well as how to make adjustments, in the next video. Once the program is set, check the bottom right corner of the page. If it shows Design Mode, click on Link Compile Connect to compile the program. Then click on Link Compile Download. If the bottom right corner shows active, downloaded, you can now debug it online. Step 3. Write the program into the DSP. If you want to run the program offline, you need to write the program to the DSP. Click on Hardware Configuration to enter the Hardware Configuration page. Select ADAU1701, right-click, and choose Write Latest Compilation to E2 PROM. An options box will appear. Simply click OK. The program will be downloaded to the ADAU1701 DSP preamp. If you accidentally set the parameters incorrectly and the preamp does not work properly, we recommend restoring the factory settings. That's the basic process of using SigmaStudio with the ADAU1701 DSP preamp. In the next video, we will dive deeper into the program and explain how to make adjustments and modifications. Stay tuned for more tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please kindly consider liking, sharing, or leaving a comment. Thank you for your support and valuable feedback.